Hello, my name is Anastasia, and this is Google Sheet Studies with Railsware. When working with large sets of data, you want to see specific subsets that match your criteria. You want to see the payments to be done this month or people who posted less working hours than expected. Google Sheets can help you with this with its simple but powerful filter functionality. Watch this video till the end to learn 5 tips and tricks about when and how to use filter. First of all, let's state that there is a difference between filter functionality and filter formula. Let's start from the basic filter functionality.
Filter provides you with a subset pulled from the original data source based on the criteria you choose. Using filter, you can see the list of values that match specific requirements. In our example, it can be payments from specific clients, regions, segments of clients, etc. Filter functionality lays in the core of Google Sheets and is presented in the main menu. You can modify your original data source for a quick view. Let's filter the payments done by clients in EMEA. I click on the column I want to use as a criteria and press Filter. If you select the column, filter will be applied to this one only. If you click on any cell with values and apply filter, it will add filters to all of the columns that contain values. It's good if you want to filter based on multiple criteria. I select the region and a new menu appears. Tick all the values you want to see and tick the values you don't want to see and press OK. If you want to choose one or two values from a huge number of options, you can clear all and click on the ones you need. The same works the other way around. Press select all and untick the values you don't want to see. An important note here. If you use this way and new data is entered, you'll have to go back to filter and tick or untick the new values again. You can also filter by a specific condition. Imagine you want to see the payments done before November 1st, 2018. You choose the column that contains the payments dates. Now we press filter and filter by condition, and you see all of the options you can use to filter data. Select the date is before and put November 1st, 2018. Now we will see only the payments done before that date. Not to set up same filters over and over again, use filter views. Press data, filter views, and create a new filter view. Name this in the top left corner, for example, North America Enterprise. Now set up the filters, so choose North America as the region and Enterprise as the segment. And close the view. If you want to see the list of payments from your Enterprise clients in North America, go back to Filter Views in the menu, and you can now see this view in the list and apply it anytime. Create as many filter views as you want.
This is all great, but you might want to do something else with your filtered subsets. For example, you want to pull only one or two columns from the set. Or you might want to do other operations based on the filtered subset, for example, to sum the payments from specific clients in the specific region. Or you might want to compare two filtered subsets between each other. And this is where basic filter functionality won't help. In these cases, we recommend you to use filter formula.
We recommend you to keep data sources and calculations on separate tabs. So let's create a new tab and call it Filtered Sets. Here come 5 key tips for using filter formula. Tip number 1. The outcome of filter formula is a set of values that match specific criteria. The outcome is listed vertically. So make sure the column for your filtered result is empty. You never know how many values you will get in the outcome, so it's better to keep one column empty for each filtered column. We type equality sign, filter, select the column to filter, which is clients, then the criteria, region to be equal to EMEA, and here are the clients based in EMEA. You can see duplicates here. To get rid of those, I apply unique to the filtered set. Tip number 2. The length of a filtered range needs to match the length of the criteria range. So if our filtered range starts from row number 2, the criteria range should also start from the row number 2. So I used A2 to A and C2 to C. Tip number 3. The formatting details for functions, dates, and currencies depend on the locale you choose. Check it in the File and Spreadsheet settings. For United States locale, I can use comma in the formula. For Poland, for example, the semicolon should be used. If you change the locale, the spreadsheet will update all of the formulas it contains now. However, if you write new functions, you have to be attentive to this. Watch our video about working with arrays in Google Sheets to learn how does locale influence the symbols you use in functions. Let's stick to the United States locale for now. Tip number 4. When working with functions, don't forget to log the values inside the function in case you want to copy or move it to another cell. To easily log the values in the formula, use F4 or F4 plus function for Mac. Anchors also help when you want to apply conditional formatting to a row. But if you don't plan to move the function or to expand conditional formatting, anchor is not obligatory. Tip number 5. Use indentation to make the formula readable. Let's format the function we have here. The filter is nested inside the unique, so the letter stays in the first line. Let's move the filter to a new line. For Mac, I use Ctrl Enter. As the filter is nested, let's move it to the right as we would do using Tab. But you can't use Tab here, so I use two spaces. If another function is nested inside filter, it can also be moved to a new line with four spaces and so on. You can separate the parts of the formula as well to make them readable. Not to get lost in parentheses you use, close each one on the level where its function starts. So I move the unique parenthesis to the new line and put it on the same level with the formula. Function names are not case sensitive. It will still work if I type filter like this. Use color coding to make your spreadsheet readable. I mark cells with formulas, outcomes, and separators. Watch our video about the spreadsheet formatting, where we explain the color coding in detail. Now, let's pull all the data about our clients from EMEA and their payments. For this, we need to expand our filtered range from A2 to H. If you need only two or three columns, feel free to adjust. We type filter, select A2 to H from payments, and select C2 to C to match EMEA. Add headers so that anyone reading it understands what does each value mean. Wrap the whole formula in braces. Add A1 to H1 from payments as headers before filter, and separate them by semicolon. Learn how to pull only specific columns that do not stand together in any order you want by watching our Filter Advanced video. Click on the card above. You can use multiple criterion filter. In this case, we add criteria to the formula separated by comma, like this. Unique, filter, select the clients as the filtered set, region to be EMEA, and client segment to be small.
If this one was too easy for you, consider watching our next video, Filter Advanced, to become a guru of filtering data in Google Sheets. We will learn how to pull any columns and order them in any way you want, how to make operations on filtered subset, and how to get rid of irritating NAs. Consider subscribing to Railsware channel and press the bell not to miss our next tutorials. If you like this video, press like for other Google users to find it faster online. See you next time!